Emmy Nights TV with head coach Scott Hetty after the Knights fall to Taylor University. And coach, this is one where you guys led the entire way, but Taylor, they never went away. They kind of hung around that 10-8 point mark, and you just never could really get rid of them.
Well, I think it was just two different halves, and I, we got some defensive stops, we got transition baskets in the first half. And I think we had energy on the defensive end, and I think we held them to 34% field goal percent in the first half. Got a lead, and we talked about how we got to keep our defense going. We're not hitting shots like we were. We got to keep it going on the defensive end, and that's what happened. We just couldn't buy a basket there for a while. Wes had some good looks, and they just didn't fall. Sterling had some good looks. Those guys, I think, combined for 17 points tonight, and we're usually getting, 37 to 40. I just think that in the second half, we didn't have the energy, defensively, getting loose balls, loose rebounds that we had in the first half because, the offense wasn't going like we want it to. And we got to learn to, no matter what happens, we got to lock in on the defensive end. And that just didn't happen. We got to learn from it. Give them credit. They kind of hung around and chipped away. It's a disappointing loss. Where we are in the league and what we've been doing here. We just got to bounce back. We're still in the mix, and we got to come back and prepare for Tuesday.
Not hitting shots, that's something that'll happen every now and then, but how did you feel about your team's execution? Did you feel like people were still coming down and doing what they needed to do, just the shots weren't going in?
For the most part, now we didn't get stops, like we did in the first half, and we had some good transition baskets and things, and they kind of took that away. I don't think we took advantage. We were in the bonus, probably about 8 minutes to go in the game, and we just couldn't get to the free throw line. And we talked about, in several timeouts, how we got to space the floor and drive the ball. And we just didn't get to the free throw line. So a lot of positive things for, 30 minutes. But we got to, we don't have the luxury of doing that. We got to play 40 minutes, and especially on the defensive end.
You guys are going to play an Indiana Wesleyan team that's really good here on Tuesday. This team's seen adversity throughout the season. How do you feel that they have reacted to adversity up until this point? Do you feel this is a team that can bounce back and be good to go Tuesday?
Well, we're going to find out, because we're right down in the thick of things, and you got six games to go. Like I said, we're in the mix, and there's a lot of things that can happen here in the next 3 weeks. So we just need to, think big picture of where we want to be in 3 or 4 weeks, and just take them one game at a time and be as prepared as we can be each night. And if we do that, if we just lock in each night to who we're playing, I think we can play with anybody. But our margin for error is, not great at times. So we have to do certain things consistently for us to be able to, to win consistently. And that's defend an entire game, rebound, and take care of the basketball. And for the most part, we did that. Other than defensively, we had some lapses in the second half.